Hello friends, I am Niranjan Kumar. I teach English at Raj Kamal Saraswati Vidya Mandir Dhanbad. Today we are to discuss relative pronoun. While teaching you pronoun, I talked about relative pronoun, but today we will discuss relative pronoun in details. You might see the word prokanj. I often call it prokanj. While going through all the parts of the speeches, you didn't go through anyone named prokanj. In fact, I call it prokanj because a relative pronoun works as a conjunction as well as a pronoun. That is why I call it prokanj. The most common one that we use is who, whom, which, that, what. The question arises, where to use who, whom, where to use which, where to use that, where to use what. Very simple. When the antecedent, now you might be thinking what this antecedent is. Okay. Antecedent is the word that comes before the relative pronoun. In other words, a relative pronoun refers the antecedent. It comes for the antecedent. So when the antecedent is a human being, we use who or whom, depending on the case. When the antecedent is animal, thing or clause, we use which. Here you might be thinking, what do you mean by clauses? Actually, when antecedent is a word, then there is no problem. See whether it is a human being, it is referring an animal, or it refers a thing. And you can easily judge to use who or which. But if the antecedent is the whole clause acts as an antecedent, only which can be used. Whether it is a human being, it refers to animal or thing, it doesn't matter. The third one is that. In your book of grammar, you might have seen written or. I don't use that. Just write human beings, animal, things, but only way a definite noun. A definite noun. Because when I say human being, the question must be with you. Where to use who? Where to use that? You might be asking, use who when the antecedent is a human being. Now you are telling, use that when the antecedent is a human being. You told when the antecedent is an animal, thing, use which. Now you are telling when the antecedent is an animal or a thing, use that. So where to use which, where to use that, where to use who, where to use that, we will discuss with sentences. Now the next one is what. What when there is no antecedent. When there is no antecedent, we use what. Am I clear? See this note also. Actually, the use of that needs a little knowledge about defining clauses. When a defining clause contains all, none, anything, nothing, the same, the little, the plus superlative degree adjective. It must be that. Am I clear? Just see. See if the sentence is, it will be very clear to you. See the first sentence. They rewarded Raju, who taught us computer application. Now just break the sentence into parts of the speech and it will be clear to you. I did it. They is acting as subject. Rewarded is verb. Raju, object of this verb. This is a relative pronoun. Taught. Now the second verb, first verb is here. Second verb. Us, object, another object, indirect of two objects. Some transitive verbs are di-transitive, means they take two objects. Now see the sentence. They rewarded Raju, taught us. Now see, there is a subject, there is a verb, subject one, verb one. There is an object, object one. Now come, there is a verb, there is an object. Is it possible that a sentence can have a verb without a subject? No, it cannot be. It means we need a subject here. We need a subject here, and that should be who? It should be who? I told you that this relative pronoun acts as a pronoun. It also acts as a conjunction. Now see, when it acts as a pronoun, it can be a subject, it can be an object. And here it is working as a subject of this one. So who is wrong? Who should be there? Now come to the second sentence. They rewarded Raju, who we were following. We were following. Now see once again, subject one, they rewarded, verb one. Raju, object one, who is a relative pronoun. We, subject two, verb, helping verb, and following verb two. Again you see, there is a subject, there is a verb, there is an object. Subject two, verb two. What do we need? We need an object. We need an object. Because if there is another subject, we must have either a conjunction to join two subjects or a verb, but we don't have. So this is wrong. And use who? Am I clear? Now come to the next sentence. Raju helped the man whom he thought had cancer. Again, break the sentence. Raju is a subject. Help, a verb. The man, an object. This is a relative pronoun. He, another subject. Thought, verb. Had, another verb. Cancer, object. Here had is not a helping verb. Here had is a main verb. Am I clear? Because when has, have, had, or any helping verb is used, it must be followed by a main verb. There is no main verb. So you can easily understand it is a main verb. Verb 3. Now see, the same problem is here. Subject 1, verb 1. Subject 2, verb 2. Verb 3, but where is subject 3? We don't have subject. It means this is wrong and we should use subjective case, that is who. Who he thought had cancer. Am I clear? To see some other sentences, he saw a boy who was carrying a bag on his head. It is correct. Now, if I say the boy, see what did I say while teaching you that definite noun. Now, the noun is definite and you can use either who or that. Now, next one, the same boy, he saw the same boy. What did I tell you? If the defining clause contains all, none, anything, nothing, the same, the little, the plus superlative degree adjective, only that will be used. So in this case, we are going to have only that. Am I clear? You can see the same thing with he bought a bag. He bought a bag. Now, a bag, a thing, again you can should break it. Subject, verb, object, verb, main verb, preposition, object. Whenever a preposition comes, just keep it in your mind. Whenever a preposition is used, it must have a noun and that acts as object of the preposition. Now see, this bag, a bag is a thing and that's why we should use which. Now if I change it, just let me have some space here. If I change it to the bag, now I can have which as well as that. Both are correct. But if there is a question where both the options are given, you should go for that. Both are correct, but that is preferred when both the options are there. And if you have the same thing, the same bag, now only one option is applicable, that is that. Clear to you? Now come to the another one. He blames others for his failures. There are people, there are students in your class also who is in habit of blaming others for his failure. He blames others for his failures. That is not liked by his friends. What is not liked by his friends? Failures. His. Others. No idea. I told you that a relative pronoun is used for the antecedent. It refers the antecedent. Now you have to find out the antecedent. That is used for he. No. That is used for failures. No. Just to see the sentence, break the sentence first, then it will be clear to you. He is the subject, blames verb, others object of this verb, for preposition, failures object of the preposition. This his is a positive adjective. Now see, that relative pronoun is a form of be, adverb of negation, main verb, preposition, object of the preposition. What did you find? You find that the whole clause acts as the antecedent of this relative pronoun. And I told you that when a whole clause acts as antecedent, only one relative pronoun can be used, and that is which. Which? Am I clear to you? Okay, now come to the next sentence. I could not understand which he taught study. I could not understand which he taught study. Break the sentence. Subject, helping verb, adverb of negation, main verb, relative pronoun, subject to, verb to, adverb of time. Now see, he taught study. I could not understand what could I not understand. Is it given? No. The antecedent is not present here. If I write, I could not understand the chapter which he taught study, then it is all right. If I say, I could not understand the technique which he taught study, it is all right. But when it is not given, the sentence is not correct. I told you that when there is no antecedent, when antecedent is not present, we can use only one relative pronoun, what. And thus, here we should use what and not which. Okay, friends, actually, whenever a video is suited, it is to benefit you, and it can be beneficial if you go through the lesson and work on it. I request you all to work on the exercises given in your book, whatever book you are having. It doesn't make any difference. There must be some exercises. Do them. And if you find any problem, you are free to call me. My telephone number is given in the link. You can communicate through WhatsApp also. The WhatsApp link is also with you. Okay? Thank you.